Today we will start a new chapter, thermal expansion. Okay, in thermal expansion, we'll be studying about the application of heat and then the result the substance will undergo. When the substance is heated, it will expand, whether it is solid, liquid, or gas. That is called expansions. Now, the chapter name is expansion in solids. So basically, most of the time we will be dealing with the solid expansion. Then to start this chapter, thermal expansion, we will define few terms like what is temperature, heat, and how to measure a temperature with what instrument. The instrument is called the thermometer. So introduction will give about the definition of temperature and the heat, and then thermometer. Then we'll proceed further. Now, temperature. What is a temperature? Temperature is basically a measure of hotness or coldness of the body. That means if you take any object, it has its own temperature because of its thermal energy, internal thermal energy. Then how high is the temperature, or how hot the body is, how cold the body is? The hotness and the coldness is measured in terms of temperature. If the temperature is high, the body is said to be hot. If the temperature is low, the body is said to be cold. So temperature is a degree of coldness and hotness of the body. It is a degree of hotness or coldness of a body or a system. Okay. Now, it is that physical quantity. It has it is measured with instrument like a thermometer, and there can be various scales of temperature. Okay, like degree centigrade, Fahrenheit, absolute scales. So there are few scales where you measure temperature. That we'll discuss later on. Heat is, as far as heat is concerned, heat is basically energy. Okay, heat is energy. It's a form of energy like sound, light, electrical, mechanical. So heat is also one energy, which energy basic tendency is to flow. So this heat energy flows because of the temperature difference. When two bodies have different temperatures, if we make an arrangement that there is a contact between the two objects, then the heat will flow from a body, that heat energy will flow from a body at high temperature to a body at low temperature. It is not that it is never possible to that heat or heat energy on its own travel from body at low temperature to a body at higher temperature. It is always from a body at higher temperature to a body at low temperature, not vice versa. So spontaneous flow of heat is always from body at high temperature to a body at low temperature. So this heat energy is basically energy that flows because of the difference in temperature between the two bodies. So so from high temperature to low temperature, that means heat flows because of temperature difference. Temperature doesn't flow because of heat difference. Okay, so that is the thing, that the flowing quantity, the quantity that flows, is the heat, not temperature. Temperature is the intrinsic property of the body. Okay, when there is a high temperature, the heat will start flowing from a body at high temperature to a body at low temperature. So this is heat, is energy, is temperature, is substance, is quantity, whose units are like degree centigrade. This is measured in degree centigrade, or degree Fahrenheit, or Kelvin. Here it is measured in joule, or you can measure in any other system of units like hertz, or like, you know, that CC system, or NK system of unit. Now, what about the thermometer? There are about thermometer. So, thermometer is basically a device. It is a device which measures the temperature of the body or system. It there are various types of thermometer, like you have alcohol thermometer, resistance thermometer, then we have gas thermometer. Okay, in case of that means a substance, when you heat a substance, if it varies, if that property varies, that substance is taken, is used as a used in thermometer. Okay, that is like in thermistor, if you heat a heat the resistance, then the temperature will change very fast. The change in resistance is very fast in case of thermistor. Similarly, if you heat a gas, then its pressure might change due to the change in temperature. So there are various types of thermometers. Basically, it's a device. It is a device to measure temperature of the body or system. Various types are there. We are not interested in all these types of thermometers. And next we will proceed to, because in our next video, the different scales of temperatures, that will discuss about the centigrade scale, Fahrenheit scale, absolute scale. These are mostly used. So we will discuss about these three scales of temperature. Okay, thank you.